Melton, really good to see you again. I'm really excited that we have a new guest today. It is Nick Krem. Nick, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm really excited. I love what you have going on here, and I'm excited that you brought me on your show.
I'm really excited too. And my aspiration is to one day be like as confident and comfortable on camera as you are. So that's what we're going to.
You could have fooled me, Aaron. You could have fooled me right off the bat.
Good deal. So anyways, Nick, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got started in real estate.
Wow. I got started in real estate about 6 years ago, kind of by accident. I just started looking for my first sales job and, you know, I wasn't finding anything. I was 20 years old at the time. I thought 21, 20 years old at the time. And I was reaching out to all these sales positions and they're like, oh, you had to have experience. I'm sorry. You don't have experience. I'm like, oh crap. Like, and then I was about to begin started working at a factory job. And that if I did that, my life would have been like done. I would have been there for the rest of my life. Right.
Right.
And then my cousin's husband actually reached out to me and he's like, hey, I heard through your brother. He actually meant to hire my brother, but he was in North Carolina. Right. He's like, I heard through your brother, you're looking for a sales job. And then I got started as an ISA. I was calling 15-hour days. I would call 8 a.m. on the East Coast to 8 p.m. on the West Coast. And I'll tell you what, you want to know inauguration by fire? It's hopping on the phones, calling FSBO, Expired, Circle Dial all day long. So I got to know the industry pretty quickly because I was in the back end of so many different agents across the country. Different brokers, different value propositions. What are they doing with their team? What are some of the specials and deals that they're doing? So I got to learn a lot about what real estate agents do to build their business. And that's how I got started in real estate.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah. Well, that's amazing. You did something that most people, you know, including myself, 20 years in next month that are terrified to do. So kudos to you. Hats off to you. What would you say that your why is, Nick?
Ooh, so I think for the longest time, for me, my big why was I played a little bit of college ball, right? Kind of messed that up a little bit, right? So I spent a couple years trying to convince myself that it was for other reasons besides myself, like not giving it my full. It's kind of messing around, going and partying, doing all that,
right?
And you know, giving up on something that you absolutely love, it was the worst feeling ever. And I have no one to blame but yourself. Right. So when I found this again, all of a sudden, like my passion came back. My fire within me came back. And so up until now too, I still remind myself some of those days, it's like, it's not always going to be your favorite day, but I know the feeling of kind of giving up on yourself. And that was the worst feeling ever. I never, ever want to feel that again. Mm-hmm. So like each and every day I wake up, I'm like, man, I love what I do. I love what is going on here. I'm going to push through the trenches. I'm going to push through the hard times. My big why is never giving up on myself again. I guess
that's a good one. That's a really, really important one. And I think it's really important for people, anyone that's going to be successful at anything in their life. You've got to go through something like that in your life. You've got to feel that hurt. You've got to feel that like, oh, I don't like this person I'm looking at in the mirror.
And
just kind of always remembering that it's like, if you're ever getting kind of low, getting low and going, I will never be to that place again. And it's like, this in you, time to kick it into gear. I get it.
That was really it. When I looked myself in the mirror and it's like, all of a sudden you start like not even recognizing yourself and it's not a good feeling.
No.
You know, it's getting back to your core values. And I think that's one thing that, the new company you really introduced it to me. I still have it on to this day. I haven't taken it off in 6 years.
I love it.
Give it to somebody and then put a new one on. It's 100% accountability, zero excuses.
It's good.
A way that we do business and it's a way I live my life now. You know, everything that happens in my life, I can hold myself accountable for better or worse.
That's great. So talk to us a little bit about creating content for your business. I know that's your thing. Tell us a little bit more about it.
Yeah. So like when we create content for our business, I always like getting into business is what we do. It's not who we are. So when we're creating this content, you know, a lot of times we're so focused on, here are five things you need to do to grow your business. Here are five things you need to do to sell your home quicker. Mm-hmm. Don't get me wrong. Some of those videos can be great.
Yeah.
People buy people. We're in the people industry, right? So if I'm watching your videos, I'm not feeling personally connected to you. I'm not feeling emotionally connected to you. I'm going to go with somebody else who is, you know, and at the end of the day, I like looking at content is like social media is the new CRM. Right? Mm-hmm. It's the social CRM.
It really is.
All these posts that we have, this is our drip campaigns that we have on people, right? Because I always say we have to meet people where they're at. Where are people at? They're on social media all day, every day.
Yep.
So what we need to, like with this content, we have to keep in mind that every time we create a video, it's like a drip into their mind, right? It's like a drip into the mind. And what else can you do on, what else can you do on a CRM? You can message people. You can message people on social media. You can call people. You can send video messages. You can do dang near everything you could do on a CRM and more through social media. So with creating content, a lot of times, don't get me wrong. We have some great business ideas like this interview right here. It's a great way to have like that business interaction too. But I also love the questions I love the questions you're asking too, because it's more than just business. It's connecting with other humans. It's creating relationships. We have a saying with our company, the difference between a contact and a contract is the R, the relationship that you have with them, right? Yep. So you form stronger relationships, you'll get more contracts. So content's a great way to create more relationships. I like thinking about it as relationship branding.
That's a good way of putting it. Yeah, that really is a good way of putting it. So that's awesome. So what would your adolescent self not recognize about Nick today?
Wow. That is a great question. What would my adolescent self not recognize about me? Oh, that I'd be in white collar business, right?
Okay.
My entire family was always like, we're all blue collar workers, right?
Okay.
It's all very much working by hand. I remember my dad growing up, I debunked his theory here, but he would say like, oh, I had kids for free labor. And then I started thinking about, I'm like, man, that's the most expensive free labor.
That wasn't a very good business investment for sure.
At the time, it made me like I was on the roof at like 7, 8 years old, like helping them with the roofing, you know, like redoing the house. Like I was always that plus one that I was always getting thrown into it, myself and my brother. So like my entire life, it was all hands-on, you know, work is hands-on. You feel, you see what you do. It's physical labor. Right. So right now, being on camera and calling this work, that would have blown my mind. I would not even think it was an option.
You and me both.
Yeah. For me too. It's, you know, I live in Florida now. I got a place down here in Florida. I'm from Cleveland. That would be something else I don't recognize. Me being able to get a mobile generator and go work from the basketball court from a day and just type up and then message people, call people, and then go shoot hoops in between. I would not recognize that because I thought it was like a myth that you can do things like that.
Yeah.
So for me, it was almost like I always assumed that work would be something I just have to do every day.
Right.
Not to say I don't work every day, but it doesn't always feel like it. That it was 9 to 5, go to work, and then have some time after. And now it's I'm going to the beach, setting up for the day. I'm working from the beach. I thought that life was just like in storybooks or like in movies. Mm-hmm. And now it's like I get to live that every single day.
That's amazing. Yeah. That's really great. That's really great. What does being part of EXP and more specifically the Honey Badger Nation, how does that feel to you?
Well, I don't know if I could show it on here, but I do have a Honey Badger tattoo. So that it means a lot to me, really. It really does. So that was, I don't know if we'll get into that here, but you know, it really does mean a lot to me with more so the collaboration and the type of leaders that are involved in this and the people we're partner with. You know, they were a big reason that I decided to start. They are the reason that I decided to start my own company and live this kind of life.
Okay.
For me, it's more than just business. They push people, like the group really pushes you to become the best version of yourself.
They really do.
They really push you and they make it. They're real. That's one of my favorite things is like they're real people. Like you can sit down, you could talk to the top producers and you would never even guess it. You can sit down, you can talk to Jay Kinder who sold 531 homes in a year. You would never guess it. These are real people doing amazing things and absolutely nothing against them. But when you sit down and talk to them, it's like, you don't have some type of superpower. Like, you're not literally like some like ultra human who has these amazing things. They just break it down. It's like, hey, you follow a system, you follow a process, you put in more work, you put in these good habits, right, and you can get there too. So for me, it's not just looking at someone at a pedestal and never seeing the path of how to get there.
Yes.
They will lay down the path, give you exactly what you need, and then it's our responsibility to take it. Exactly. So I think the most amazing thing about this group is they show you, they don't just tell you what it takes to get there. They show you what it takes, and they want you to become that successful. They want you to become more successful than them.
Right. Right. Yeah. And that really is, that is a novel feeling, particularly if you haven't, I've been thinking about it, that with this network, and I'm very much of a, and I think the same for you, that it's like that concept of work and things, it's hands-on. Like if you are physically and mentally able to do something, I've never been scared of hard work, that it's like you get out there and do that. And that concept of being on video, that it's like, this is working or this is helping people is like, okay, really, this is how it is. And then meeting these people and interacting with these people, it almost feels like you were born into old money. That's what makes me think of, right?
Yeah.
That you've been born in old money, and that so you're just naturally going to rub elbows with all these people through school, through life, and all these opportunities are going to be open to you because of who you know.
Yes.
And you know, you went to Ivy League schools and all these different things, right?
Yeah.
And it's realizing that you feel like you're part of this, but it's a group of really genuine, real people that have come from very different backgrounds, most of them very humble, and have worked themselves up and have proved that a lot of it just takes that desire, that fire to want to achieve something, and knowing that you want to be your very best and be able to look at yourself in the mirror every day and go, you know what? You did okay at this, but you can prove that. But remember, you never want to go back to that part again.
Exactly. And I love the way you say it. It's like everyone that went to that Ivy League school, except a lot of them didn't, like myself. No. Like, I didn't finish college. I know a lot of the people in the group that didn't either.
I didn't either.
And it's really a great, you know what? It's a seat at the table. I think that's what they really offer you. It's a seat at the table to hear, to listen, to be a fly on the wall sometimes. And just listen to how others think. Listen to how they process problems in business and figure out ways that it's not about the problem, it's about the solution. And it's when you sit at the table, they make you believe that, like, man, I deserve to be here too,
right?
Until I get there.
That's a really good way of putting it. That not feeling like, oh, I don't belong here, I can't believe, did they really know, you know, I just crashed this wedding, do they really know who I am, you know?
Right.
And then going, I deserve to be here, and I have something to actually bring to the group. And you certainly have brought something pretty amazing to this group. We all look at you and go, how'd you do it? How'd you do it? And then it's like, wow. No, we're really impressed. Well, Nick, thank you so much for coming on with us. If someone needed to get in touch with you about getting help about creating content for your business, what would be the best way for them to get in touch with you?
You did a great job. It's at both of these corners over here, nickkrem.com. Just my first name, last name.com. You know, we got some free stuff for agents that are on there too. You can hop in my personal calendar too to have a conversation with me. That's the best place that you guys can go.
Very good. Well, again, Nick, thank you so much for your time, and hoping that we get a chance to actually meet sometime soon at one of these events.
Yes, I hope so too. It's coming. I know it's coming. It's just a matter of when.
Very good. Well, you send some warm weather from Florida up here to Virginia, please.
Will do.
Good deal.
I'm coming up. Yeah. Okay. We'll see ya.
See ya. Bye-bye.